In this video, you'll see how you can train a computer vision model using data from AWS Data Exchange. With this capability, you can obtain large image datasets, integrate data seamlessly between AWS Data Exchange, Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3, and Amazon Sagemaker, and build customized image classification models for your needs. This is an overview of the solution components. We'll export image data from AWS Data Exchange into Amazon S3. And then use an Amazon SageMaker notebook instance to prepare and train the computer vision model. To finish, we'll deploy a model endpoint, upload a new image, and evaluate the results. Let's begin by going to AWS Data Exchange. We've already subscribed to a Shutterstock image dataset. Let's take a look. The dataset is a free collection of pre-labeled image assets of Whole Foods shoppers that can be used for training multi-label image classification models. Let's view the dataset. As you can see, we've exported the data into an Amazon S3 bucket. Now let's go to Amazon SageMaker and build a notebook for training and testing a model. We'll create a new notebook instance. Let's name the notebook and retain the default notebook instance settings. We'll create a new AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM, role for Amazon SageMaker to access the S3 bucket where we stored the Shutterstock dataset. Let's go to the AWS Data Exchange tab to copy the bucket name. Now we can create the role. To finish, let's create the notebook instance. Now that the notebook has reached an in-service status, we can move on. Let's open the notebook in Jupyter. We'll go to the SageMaker Examples tab. This is a collection of Amazon SageMaker sample notebooks. Let's find the one we need. This notebook contains a SageMaker image classification algorithm designed to work with the Shutterstock image dataset we copied to Amazon S3. Let's copy it. We can now edit and work with the Shutterstock data. Before we begin to train the model, let's go to Amazon S3 and review the dataset we'll be using. We'll search for the bucket where we exported the data. This folder contains the image files. Each image has associated metadata that we can query with S3. To do that, let's go back to the bucket and select the metadata file. Next, we'll select Actions and choose Query with S3 Select. Amazon S3 Select retrieves subsets of data from an object using standard SQL queries. The default query displays the first 5 records of input data. Let's run the query. The raw query results include the image asset ID, the file collection it's a part of, keywords, and a description. These are the labels we'll aim to predict using the image classification model. Let's return to the Jupyter notebook. We'll work through the steps and train the model. First, we'll supply the name of the S3 bucket containing the image dataset. Let's run the code. While this code executes, we can proceed with the rest of the inputs. In step 2, we'll parse the metadata CSV file to create an LST file for training. We'll input some training keywords for the model to recognize and use when labeling individual images. In step 3, we'll create the training and validation datasets. Now we'll copy the training data into our S3 bucket. In the next step, we'll set the model's training parameters. We can also specify algorithm parameters, known as hyperparameters. In step 7, we'll define the input data type. Now we can train the model. Let's run the command. After the model is trained, we can deploy the model endpoint to provide inferences. Let's run the code. Finally, we'll evaluate the model's labeling accuracy. Let's input a new image that was not used to train the model. Let's look at the results. The model associated 5 labels with the image. Next to each assigned label, we see a measurement of the model's confidence level. We can improve the accuracy of our model by training on additional labels, increasing the size of the training set, or modifying the model's hyperparameters. Once we've finished evaluating the model, we can use the command provided to discontinue the SageMaker model endpoint. You've just seen how you can train a computer vision model using data from AWS Data Exchange. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.